Hello friends, welcome back once again in the video lecture series of Theory of Computation. In the last lecture, I have taught you some basic concept of Theory of Computation and its application. And I have told you on the basis of their application, mainly Theory of Computation is centralized between four machines. First one is known as FA, that is a finite automata, right? FA means finite automata. So we have to study about finite automata. Next one is your PDA, that is push down automata, right? Next one is your LBA, that is linear bounded automata. And last one is your TM, that is Turing machine. That means the study of theory of computation is centralized to study these four machines, right? Fine. Second point I have here deduced that every machine has its own languages and their own grammar. Now, what does it mean? It means, in the previous lecture, I have already taught you that TOC is mainly used in compiler design in various phases. Like, finite automata is used in lexical analysis, PDA, that is pushdown automata, is used in syntax analysis, and LBA is used in semantic analysis. That means they have their own languages and their grammars. That means the languages should be accepted by this machine. If the language will be correct, then it should be accepted, otherwise it should be rejected. So for this reason, in TOC we have to also study about languages. What are languages? What are functions? What are finite automata, pushdown automata, that I will cover in the latter section. In this video, I am just making your introduction with these new terminologies, right? Next one is known as grammar. That means, on the basis of grammar, you can design languages which should be accepted by different machines. In the third point, I have covered this point, that grammar is used to design the language which should be accepted by different machines. What are the different machines? That is FA, PDA, LBA and TM. That means that for these four different machines, we are having different grammars. And if we are having different grammars, certainly we will design different types of languages. Right? Okay, fine. So, if I am telling you that in theory of computation we have to study about four types of machine, these are the machines, then certainly for these four types of machine, we will be having four types of languages, right? And to design these four types of languages, we should have four types of grammars. So mainly what we have to study in theory of computation, mainly we have to study about different grammars, different languages and different machines, right? Next point is given as, to understand the basic concept of language and machine, we have to understand the concept of what are the alphabets, that I will let you know in the further lectures, right? And on the basis of alphabets, how we can create new strings, right? And on the basis of these strings, how the language are generated. That means, first of all, we have to study about some alphabets, right? On the alphabets, strings are created or constructed or designed, and on the basis of strings, the languages are designed. And these languages are, these different languages are accepted by different machines. Let us discuss about Chomsky hierarchy. So, before explaining about Chomsky hierarchy, let me introduce you first full form of these four machines that I have already discussed. FA is for finite automata, PDA is for pushdown automata, LBA is for linear bounded automata, and TM is for Turing machine. Right? The language which is accepted by finite automata is known as regular language. What are regular language? I will surely teach you in detail, right? But here I want to take I want to make you understand ki why Chomsky hierarchy is important for you, right? So regular languages is accepted by finite automata. Next, the languages which is accepted by push-down automata is known as context-free languages. Context-free languages is also known as CFLs in short. Next one is known as LBA, that is linear boundary automata, and for that the language accepted is context-sensitive language, that is CSL. And for Turing machine, the language which is accepted by Turing machine is REL, that is recursive enumerable languages. Now, what does Chomsky hierarchy tells? Chomsky hierarchy tells about the relationship between these four languages which are accepted by these four machines respectively, right? So we are having four types of languages, and these four types of languages are somehow related with each other according to the Chomsky hierarchy. For that reason I have explained you in this way. Now I will tell you how these languages are interrelated with each other according to the Chomsky hierarchy. Chomsky hierarchy has given four circles in concentric circle manner, right? The inner core is represented by type 3, that is type 3 language is REG. That is, what is REG? That is regular grammar, right? And uske upar jo hai, that is a type 2 language. Type 2 language is CFL, that is context-free language. After that, type 1 is there, which is CSL, that is context-sensitive language. And first one is known as your type 0 REL, that is type 0 language, that is recursive enumerable language. Now through this Chomsky hierarchy, Chomsky wants to tell that type 3 is subset of type 2. Right? And type 2 is subset of type 1. And type 1 is again subset of type 0. That means, in other words, we can say that the type 1 is superset of type 2, and type 2 is superset of type 3, sorry, it is type 1. Type 1 is superset of type 2, and type 2 is superset of type 3. Moreover, this is accepted by finite automata. REG is accepted by finite automata. This is accepted by PDA, that is push-down automata. This is accepted by CSL, is accepted by LBA, and this is accepted by your Turing machine, that is TM. So as a whole, Chomsky has tried to make the relationship in between these four languages, and he call it as that REL is termed as type 0, CSL is termed as type 1, CFL is termed as type 2, and RG is treated as type 3. Among all of these four languages, the most restricted language is REG, that is regular language. Regular language is the most restricted language, and most free language is your TM, right? Most restricted language is your REG, and most free language is known as your recursive enumerable language. So last one is your REL, that is recursive enumerable language. For more detection, he has observed that through this diagram he has told that every regular language can be treated as CFL, but every CFL is not treated as regular language. Similarly, every CFL, that is every context-free language, can be treated as context-sensitive language, but all context-sensitive language are not CFL. right? Similarly, every CSL can be treated as REL, but not all REL will be as CSL, right? For that reason only, here he has given this observation that type 3 is subset of type 2, is subset of type 1, and is subset of type 0. That is, what is the superset? Type 0 is the superset, and what is the super subset? This type 3 is the super subset.